G'day folks. I attended a introduction to permaculture course put on by Michael and Megan of Save Your Soil Permaculture on the weekend, and we came across a beehive. It's actually a beehive I've known about for quite a while, but there's a new addition to the little tree where the bees have set up home. It's just this camphor laurel tree behind me here. You can see the little box that someone's put up around an entrance. That there is an European bee, honeybee, or an Italian honeybee, and there's also an Australian native honeybee that has set up a little hive in the same tree. So I thought it'd just be interesting to bring you along and show you, you know, how they're living together. Also too, a big shout out and a big thank you to Luke, a new friend of ours. Luke, g'day mate. He attended the same introduction to permaculture course with us, and he's an avid beekeeper. He's been doing it for many years, and he gave me a bit of a rundown of what we saw and what we observed with the hive. So thank you very much for that, Luke. I really do appreciate it. Bianca dropped the camera off and we had a bit of a chat about what was going on, so I thought I'd just tack together a bit of a clip and yeah, show you what the hives look like. So here's the camphor laurel tree the bees have set up home in. There's a bit of a hollow down the base here. Someone's tried to board them in by the look of it, or board them out at some point in time. So we'll get in a little bit closer, set the camera up and give you a bit of a look at what's going on. We were here yesterday and we noticed that there was a bit of funny activity going on. Some of the larger bees were being dragged out by the smaller workers. So what was going on there, Luke?
What you've got is the drone bees, which are males. And during winter time, the males don't really have very much of a role within the hive. So the female bees, the worker bees, they tend to drag the males out and kick them out of the hive. The males then fly off and they end up dying in the cold.
Yeah.
But it preserves the hive because of the limited stores of honey and food in the hive. And so they get rid of those mouths to feed, extra mouths to feed, basically. To help preserve the hive.
So how large do you reckon the hive is in that tree?
At the moment that hive's probably got about 50,000 bees sitting in it. It's hard to tell exactly how big the hive would be. I'd say it'd go fair way down to the ground sort of level, and maybe up to where it forks in the branch, or maybe a little bit further.
Just having a bit of a closer look at the hive in there, and the honeycomb is pretty visible. There's a lot of bees fanning around the entrance there. What are they doing, mate?
They're doing a couple of different things. One thing is that they're cooling the hive. So we're almost midday here at the moment, and the sun's beaming straight into that entrance, and it tends to heat the hive up a lot. Being wood, obviously, it holds a lot of the heat in.
Yeah.
And so the bees want to keep their main focus is keeping the brood at a optimal temperature for brood rearing. If it gets too cold or too hot, the brood dies. So they're fanning to keep that nice and cool. Another thing that they do is they also fan the honey. The nectar that they bring in is quite high in moisture, and they want to get rid of that moisture, and fanning obviously gets rid of the moisture and turns it into honey.
Okay, cool. So it's serving a few different purposes.
Yeah, a few different purposes,
yeah.
But being able to see that at the entrance tells you that, you know, it's a fairly healthy hive at the moment. They're bringing in lots of stores, and they got brood underway as well.
Yeah, and I just saw one crawl down the side there with big pollen sacs.
Yeah, that's another good indicator of them rearing up their brood.
Yeah.
Because they feed their young pollen.
Yeah.
So it's another good indicator. If they're bringing in lots of pollen, then they've got lots of babies, mouths to feed.
Yeah, so they've got the next generation coming through well.
Yep.
I just saw one fly in with a bright white sac and another one with a bright orange. So they're feeding off different sources then? Like that one there is white.
So pollen-wise, they'll go to anything, but nectar, they'll only feed on one species at a time.
Okay. So I've just been sitting here and observing these bees over lunch, and Bianca just pointed out that there's a small native just flew out of this hive, and Luke suggested, there's one buzzing around the entrance there, Luke suggested that what could be going on is these two hives could be linked in some fashion, but the hole's small enough for the natives to come through, but the Europeans can't go out the other way. So I mean, it's all just supposition. We don't know what's going on in there, really. I mean, the bee could have just been coming around to borrow a cup of honey. Who knows? Just to give you some idea on how close these two hives are together, there's the European bees down there. And just up here in this knot, we have the entrance. to the native beehive. As you can see, a lot of bees bringing in fresh pollen, so it's a very active, very healthy looking hive. There's around about 1500 species of Australian native honeybees. Of those though, there's only about 10 that live in a social environment like these guys, that is, they make a hive. They're not fantastic honey producers, nowhere near the Europeans, but what they do is they provide a service of pollinating plants. Small flowers, delicate flowers, these guys are small enough that they can get in there and do the job. A lot of people actually keep them in their backyards. You can put them in small hives and they will survive quite successfully in there, and you can also, you know, obtain a bit of a yield honey-wise from them, but yeah, like I said, nowhere near like the Europeans. The Australian natives set up their hives a lot different from the European bees. They actually create a bit of a spiral, something we were lucky enough to see when we visited some friends we made online. G'day Alex and family. They keep the native bees in their backyard and they had to split a hive, invited us along and we had a bit of a look. They form a spiral comb in the center that houses the brood, and then off to the side they have little storage pots, or pods I suppose, where they store the honey and also the pollen to feed the brood. So a lot different than the traditional comb of the normal European bee. We found that very fascinating and we were really interested in getting a small native hive for the yard. Just something that hasn't happened as of yet, but it will at some point in time. And all, like I said before, we're really interested in hooking up with Luke and maybe setting up a hive of the Europeans in the yard as well, once we work out where everything's going to be situated. So there you go, I thought that might interest a few people. So I just want to thank Luke.
Not a problem.
Thank you very much, mate, for giving me a bit of a lesson in bees over the last couple of days. I've thoroughly enjoyed it, and like I said, I'm actually starting to contemplate maybe getting a hive once our yard's been sorted out the right way. So there you go, folks, there's a bit of a look at the beehives in the tree at the local community centre. I was really chuffed to find out on Saturday when I turned up for the introduction to permaculture course that the natives have moved in. It was great to be able to share those guys with you as well, especially, you know, seeing as they're living in the same tree. Also too, like to thank Michael and Megan for putting on the day and introducing me to a whole heap of new local mates. So thank you very much, it was great to meet you all. And also too, especially to Luke, thank you very much, mate, for giving me a bit of an explanation on what was going on there with the hive on the weekend. Really appreciate that. As always, you can leave any comments, questions or suggestions in the comments section below and I will get back to you where I can. So other than that, I'd like to thank you all for coming along and checking out the bees, and I'll catch you next clip. Cheers, folks.
You know, I could sit here all day.
Yeah, I was just telling Michael before, down in Canberra, we were just on a small house block and that's pretty much all there was, the house, and that's all you could fit on there. And most of my hives I kept out at a farm, but I had one hive at home that I put in the at the front window, at the bedroom window. So it was between the, it was in the front garden, but between the footpath, sort of in the house.
Yeah.
And I had it so that the entrance would face the bedroom window, and Kirsty'd come home many days and find me asleep at the window because I'd just been sitting there watching the hive.